Hello and welcome to this video tutorial for webcam streaming with Streaming Video Provider. So what you would need to do first is log into your panel. In your panel, to start, we would need to either create a new live broadcast or use a previous one that we have created already by clicking on the Broadcast Now button. However, for this tutorial, I'm going to create a brand new one. So I'm going to click on it and it's going to bring us to the settings for the new player. So on the live player, I'm going to call it My Live Broadcast. And I'm going to ignore all these settings that I have available here for the moment because I don't need them, but yes, you can change them to your own desire and click on the Save Changes button to save the new live player. Now, if we scroll down, we're going to see the new live broadcast player down here. I'm going to click on the Broadcast Now to open the broadcast panel. In the broadcast panel, I'm going to get a little message from Adobe Flash saying that we need to allow Streaming Video Provider to access the camera and microphone. All we're going to do is click on the Allow button to give it access. And we're going to start seeing a video feed now. In the video feed, we have, in the broadcast panel itself actually, we have three different things. We've got the video feed from our webcam, we've got a local preview of our webcam, and then we also have the live player which would be placed in our website. You can place the live player on your website by simply copying the player link, or copying the embed code to embed it into your website. Or you could go back here and click on the publish button and choose one of the publishing methods such as embedded, player link, and Facebook and Twitter. So once you have placed the player on your website, come back to the broadcast panel. And in the broadcast panel, we're going to do a couple of things now. First, we're going to click on the show settings button to see our webcam settings. Our webcam settings, we have a few major things. One is the volume of the microphone, which we can obviously increase or decrease the volume. And we also have, if we want to enable or disable the volume altogether, as well as which microphone to use. We also get for video settings the aspect ratio, the overall quality of the resolution that we have chosen. So you can choose different types of resolutions and which video camera to feed from. So at the moment, I'm using my FaceTime HD camera here. These settings can actually be changed on the fly whilst doing your live event streaming, which is amazing. So if you're doing a stream and you want to just change something in your live stream, just simply go here, click on this, change it on the fly, so you don't have to stop the live event to do your changes of settings. So I'm happy with the settings I have here. I'm going to send full HD at full quality, so I'm absolutely comfortable with that. Also, the system changes the settings and the transmission dynamically on depending on the quality and the available broadband speed that you have. So the settings won't be shown here, but if you have a low broadband speed, it will know that when you have the quality on maximum, it will reach its maximum point depending on the broadband speed that you have available. So it's a very dynamic, very powerful system. We click on publish because I'm happy with this one. It's going to send it to the local preview online. And from here, we can simply click on start broadcasting to send it to our viewers live. So we can see all the three here. So yeah, that's how easy it is to do your live stream. So you're streaming live. And now, you know, we're happy with it. We finished our live event. We simply click on the stop broadcast button to stop the live player. And to stop it completely, we just simply click on the stop to stop the local preview as well. And we're back in our own webcam. So it's as simple as that to do a great quality live event with your webcam. Thanks for watching, and I hope you'll see you again soon.